There are no words to adequately describe the horror of the moment when I learned I was HIV positive. Although I could not have asked more of my physician or his staff, their kind words could not change the finality of my diagnosis. It was the beginning of a new journey in my life, one I never would have willingly chosen. I have yet to fully explain my illness to my own two daughters, ages 4 and 8. I dread the time when they will realize that I might not be there to share the moments when they graduate from high school, get married, and have children of their own. I would give anything to be present at those times in their lives when my own mother was so important in mine. Nothing will give me back my life as it was before HIV and HCV were a part of it.
What you just heard are the words of Lisa Black, a nurse who contracted HIV and HCV through a needle stick injury at work. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention estimate that SHARPS-related injuries occur to about 600,000 healthcare personnel each year. Even outside the healthcare industry, there are numerous workers at risk for SHARPS injuries and bloodborne pathogens, many of which are life-threatening. Because of this, OSHA requires employers to protect their employees who are exposed to these hazards by following the bloodborne pathogens standard. This course was developed to assist you in meeting the requirements of the standard. Some of the topics we'll cover are determining the potential for exposure in your workplace, understanding the essential elements of an OSHA-compliant exposure control plan. We'll discuss preventing and mitigating exposures and administering your exposure control plan. As you go through the program, you'll notice words or phrases that are underlined. These words may be new to you or have new meaning as they relate to the standard, so we provided definitions that appear when you click on them. Please keep in mind, this course is not intended to be used as a substitute for reviewing the actual standard. We strongly recommend you refer to the standard for the complete rule. If you have questions along the way, please click on the Resources button in the program toolbar. There you'll find our contact information and other helpful resources related to bloodborne pathogens. Thank you for taking the time to learn more about health and safety.